You want to party? Do you invite your enemies? Do you even think about them? But Paul said,
then so,
is there anybody in the house of Saul?
David, okay, say,
that I'm showing kindness because of Jonathan's sake.
And now Jonathan, about Jonathan.
Why Jonathan?
I didn't know Jonathan.
Because there was a covenant that the two men had. Their friendship was so nice that they had a covenant. Even Jonathan was dead and gone.
Now Jonathan, who did?
But David wanted to fulfill that covenant. The same is with us today. God has a covenant. It's not a simple covenant. Not just like the one between David and Jonathan. But it was a covenant that he sealed with the son of his own. The blood of his own son. He sealed with it. So if David could think about that covenant, how much more will God not think about the covenant?
Amen.
Amen. I read verse 2. He said, verse 2 says, and there was in the house of Saul a servant whose name was Ziba. And when they have called him unto David the king, he said unto him, art thou Ziba? And he said, yes, thy servant is he. The king said, is there not yet any of the house of Saul that I may show kindness of God unto him? And Ziba said unto the king, Jonathan hath yet a son, which is lame at his feet. Amen.
Amen.
He said, Ziba, okay, is there anybody in the house of Saul? I want to show you kindness. And Ziba said, oh, there is one boy. As for that guy, he's nothing. He's even crippled at his feet. He is Apache. So that's the one left. He can't even walk. You see what is happening? The king wanted to show kindness. Here comes someone who says, the person wants to show kindness to
him.
He's a Apache. He's a cripple. I don't know what has crippled you. But when God wants to help you, instead of somebody to recommend you, here comes the point whereby the person will say, oh my Lord, stop it. The lady wants to show favor to. Oh, she can't even bear fruit. She is barren to the core. Even the womb has been released. It has been thrown into the gutter. Oh God, don't waste your time. The person you want to heal, the doctors are sweating him off. That cancer you can't cure. So God, don't waste your time. That was what Ziba was doing. But how come was this boy becoming crippled? When you go further in 2 Samuel chapter 4, the Bible says when the war had finished,
Bible said,
and the news came into town, that Jonathan was dead.
Jonathan.
And Saul was dead. The Bible says the nurse of the boy.
The Bible says,
he pick up this child and begin to run.
And
she fell. And the boy fell. And he broke his legs. That point, the boy became crippled. Come to think of it. How huge was this woman? But the Bible says she fell, so it is a woman. I don't know if I jump from here down there, I can break my legs. If my daughter of 3 years fall from my hands, she will be hurt. But not the sin of breaking her legs and become paralyzed. There's something here. When you go to the Eden Garden, she was there.
She be a baby.
Who was the she? Who was there? Our grandmother Eve.
Eve.
She dropped her so low. that all of us become crippled. That's why the Bible says in Romans that all have sinned. We have fallen short of the glory of God. He didn't say we have sat short or we have run short, but we have fallen short. So when you read the account of 2 Samuel chapter 4, the Bible says the woman fell and the boy became crippled. As a result of the disobedience of our grandma Eve, all of us we fell. We all become like crippled. The name of that boy I'm talking about is Mephibosheth. Mephi means repeller. To repel, to cast off. And Boshet means shame. Mephibosheth means repel of shame. Good one. So you and I, we have been crippled. Our situation had become like Mephibosheth. And after all this while,
now where would you actually?
David inquired from Ziba.
David said Ziba.
And he says, Ziba, where is he? And you know what Ziba means?
Ziba no so only message.
Ziba means strong man.
Ziba no only message will be an water.
Good. So Jonathan, that time he was alive, or so when he was alive. This Ziba was the servant of that house. He was in charge of everything in that house, including the crippled guy. So you can come to think of this. A strong man having possession over you. He, instead of him to bring Mephibosheth wherever he goes, he dumped Mephibosheth somewhere else. You and I, we are crippled. There's a strong man in charge of our lives. Instead of him to take good care of us with his strength, he has put it somewhere else. And King David asked of him, where is he? That cripple. Don't need to tell me or describe to me how the next look like. Tell me where he is. When you refer that, the Bible says, he told King David, he is in
Lodibar.
He is by one man we call
Machir.
He is living with him. But I thought you are the servant in Saul's house. Why didn't you take care of that?